Shri is getting ready for a breakfast, kadubu breakfast.
I ate about 5-6, I cannot eat more than that.
Of coconut in this, and then there's a sour twang of lemon that you also taste, and in the yogurne there is curry leaf, saswe, mustard seeds, and loads of garlic as well. Shri is doing her yoga routine. That's our room right there. There's such peace in this area. You hear nothing here except for the sound of a solitary worker there who is working the land, the chirp of the birds, and the rustling of the dry leaves under your footsteps. So here we are at the vintage homestay, a home in a large orchard, and I'm told there's about 8 to 10 acres of plants, trees. I can see some jackfruit somewhere. I can see some jackfruit right there. And so there's the main bungalow, which has some rooms, but we are here in another villa, which is adjacent to the main bungalow. So you've got your own private sit out, a table here, that's a sit out here, and this is the room. Shri is already making herself comfortable. I think I'm just going to take a couple of shots of the room before we make ourselves comfortable. I quite like what I see, and I like the vibe of it already. Just had a short conversation with the owner, Charles Baptist, and the one thing that got us very interested in this property is the fact that the owner himself spends time in the kitchen cooking up the food for his guests along with his chef. And I'm told he does the local Malnad style combined with some Mangalorean food because he's a Mangalorean.
Nice, beautifully done up.
Oh, is something frying?
Yeah, he's frying some chicken kebabs.
Nice. So what's on the menu today for lunch?
Menu and then a nutty chicken curry.
Okay.
Neer dosa.
Okay.
Some vegetable curry. What I usually do is speak to the guests and tell them our menu. They don't like it, then I'll prepare what they want.
I just like to explore a little more vegetarian as well. Although I do a lot of non-vegetarian on my show.
Sure, sir, sure.
But you know.
Local meal is specifically.
Kalale.
Bamboo shoot. Bamboo shoot,
We are doing it.
Yeah, okay. So jackfruit is there.
Salt, then they make curry out of it.
Oh, nice.
Palya.
So you make that?
We'll do it.
My favorite actually. Yes. Jackfruit though. Palya adru agi.
Interesting lunch here. So we have some fish. This I'm told by Mr. Charles Baptist that this is the lake pomfret. So it looks pretty much like a pomfret. Looking forward to tasting it. And then we have some tender jackfruit that's cooked in this lovely preparation with some coconut. And then there's a fish curry. This is the Mangalorean style fish curry. This is with some sear fish there. And that kadubu, the pundi, some sanna, and this is a mulangi sambar, a radish sambar. Jackfruit.
No wonder it is so good.
So also known as kattal in the north. Mm. slight huli the lime akra. So you got a fleshy bite of the jackfruit, you got loads of coconut in this, and then there's a sour twang of lemon that you also taste. And in the yogurne there is curry leaf, sasve, mustard seeds, and loads of garlic as well. A delicious way to savor some jackfruit. So that garlic is basically whole cloves which have been roughly chopped. So I think you have halves. So there's a fair bit of garlic that you also bite into. So out here the vintage, they adapt the menu based on what their guests would like to eat. When I knew I was coming here, I told them that I would like to eat produce that's local. I wanted to eat things like the bamboo shoots that we tasted, the jackfruit, because this is produce that's indigenous to the region. Shri, are you enjoying the jackfruit?
Yeah.
Shri has told me today not to disturb her during her meal. So I said, okay, we won't disturb the boss. How big is this jackfruit that you cut?
It's about 1 month old. It takes about 3 months.
3 months.
Yeah.
And of course, they have an extensive jackfruit collection here. I mean, many trees. How many trees do you have of jackfruit?
What, about 50.
50?
Yeah.
Wow.
All varieties.
It's really good.
Jackfruit is good? It's very good. It's really good, the jackfruit.
Mom, this is
it. Oh, this is your mom's recipe.
Chili, the masala, ground vinegar.
With vinegar?
Vinegar.
Ah.
And again, barigi chili, and Kashmiri chili.
So the Mangalorean fish fry, there will be a bit of vinegar, no? Always.
Even for some vegetable fry also, it is the same.
The texture of this fish is more like black pomfret. And I think this bone though reminds me of a katla, right? But the flavor of this fish is very much like black pomfret. This is delicious. So the masala has a bit of the heat from the chili, but it's Kashmiri chili, Byargi chili, so it's not too spicy. And then you have a bit of that sour edge that comes from the vinegar. This is the first time I'm eating this fish. Is it commonly found in this area?
It is actually common, but guests like it. It
has a slight earthiness to the flavor as well.
That is because from lake.
Lake fish. To me, that flavor is reminiscent of that aroma that you get in the air when the first drops of rain hit the earth. I've got myself now some sanna and some fish curry. This is of course the anjal. You add tomato to your fish curry?
Yeah. We add tomatoes, pieces of ginger, some garlic.
So this is the fish curry that you would eat at home?
Yeah. We do stew also, but the stew here, what we do is we grind the coconut and directly put it to the curry. There we take out the
milk. So this is a curry, this is a fish curry that's a bit tangy in its flavors, right? That sanna soaks up that curry. Place it in your mouth and that sanna disintegrates, allowing for that curry to seep into every pore of your tongue. Began my meal with the vegetable. Tender jackfruit, close my meal with a anna sambar, but made of mulangi. Very nice and light.
Almost like a nice soup.
Yeah, it's almost like a nice soup, yeah. Barring a little bit of the Togri bale that you taste.
Oh, yeah.
Slightly.
Some vegetables that comes in it, yeah.
There's such peace in this area. You hear nothing here except for the sound of a solitary worker there who is working the land, the chirp of the birds, and the rustling of the dry leaves under your footsteps. I think we are surrounded with so much noise all the time. It's nice to break away every once in a while from all that clutter. Look at these pepper vines. I can hear the call of the peacock somewhere in the background. And yesterday we even spotted a peacock on the property. There's plenty of jackfruit. I think the raw jackfruit will make for some great vegetable preparations, the kuttal. And the ripe jackfruit, of course, sweet and luscious to eat. Shri is doing her yoga routine. That's our room right there. So Shri is doing her morning routine. I've just finished mine. Time for some coffee. Some Chikmagalur coffee. So are you going to buy some of this coffee here?
Yes, of course.
Yeah?
Yeah.
What do you want to buy from here?
Coffee, cardamom, pepper.
Coffee, cardamom, pepper. So basically all three are native to the land. So whenever you're traveling, it's always nice to buy things that are native to the land. I like my coffee to be steaming hot, but I asked them for the coffee and then I wandered off into the orchards, so it may not be steaming hot. Thanks entirely to me. The milk is steaming hot. Just a little sugar, not too much. Good morning. There's nothing that says good morning like a good cup of coffee. Ah, this is lovely. Are you done?
Super. Just 40 minutes. Nice yoga in this beautiful, you know, so nice.
There's a lovely breeze blowing through this place.
That's fantastic.
Did you also go for your walk?
Yeah, I did about 20 minute walk and 40 minute yoga. I'm done. I'm ready to eat my breakfast.
Ready? I think I will skip breakfast.
Okay.
I will watch you eat breakfast.
Yes, kadubu and two different types of chutneys and some fruits.
Kadubu, chutney and fruits.
Yeah.
Nice. So Shri is going to break down the breakfast for us. She's going to speak for the breakfast and decipher all those flavors and textures. Right?
No. That's your job. I'll just eat.
You'll just eat.
Yeah.
All right. You want to freshen up and come?
Yeah, I will.
You want to close a metal door?
Yeah, I will.
We've been warned to close a metal door because there are these frogs that get in. Whilst us city slickers may find the concept a bit icky, but that's the reality of life if you're living in a fruit orchard, right? If you're living in nature, nature is going to be a part of everything that you do, everything that you see, and it's going to be all around you. Madam, ye matra. Nimma hesare enu?
Mani, sir.
Mani. Also, very nice bunch of people here. Right from the owner, Mr. Charles Baptist. Was nice to spend some time with him yesterday and learn how he came into this homestay enterprise. It's a beautiful property. In addition to the fruit orchards, they have the main bungalow, which is very nicely built. And then, of course, this is an extension, a smaller villa. They have another bungalow on the other side. There's a petite cottage there, which is right there. And I think this villa that we are in is actually a unit of two or three interconnecting rooms. So if you're a family of, let's say, four, five or six, it makes perfect sense to kind of take something like this. Also, what I like is that the space feels very organic. It feels very rooted. So the owner is a very interesting person, very passionate about the food that he does. So he's got one cook in the kitchen, and so he goes in the morning to the market, picks up things. The meals that we had yesterday, we had lunch and dinner. I think we were nice, simple, but satisfying. Shree is getting ready for her breakfast, kadubu breakfast.
Are you sure you don't
want to eat? The kadubu, I think I will ask him to save some for lunch for me. Een curry adu?
Sambar.
Een sambar? Sautekai.
Sautekai sambar.
Okay, good. Tomato chutney and then the coconut chutney. Simple but very healthy.
So I'm going to skip breakfast because I want to stick to my intermittent schedule. So I'm having a bit of coffee, half a cup of coffee, but that's something that I also do at home. So even when I'm doing my intermittent fasting in the morning, I have about half a cup of coffee. I finished dinner yesterday at, what time did we finish?
9:30.
So I think I will try and do at least a 15-hour, 16-hour fast.
Kari baale ante helta.
Kari baale no. ಲೋಕಲ್ ಗ್ರೋ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ
ಲೋಕಲ್
ಒಳಗೆ ವೈಟ್ ಕೆಂಪ
ರೆಡ್
ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಒಳಗೆ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ದಟ್ ಯು ಸೀ ಹಿಯರ್ ದ ಬನಾನಾಸ್ ಆರ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿ ಆರ್ಚರ್ಡ್ ಹಿಯರ್
ರೈಪ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಆ ರೆಡ್ ಇದೆ
ಆ ಔರ್
ವೆರಿ ನೈಸ್
ಇಸ್ ಸ್ವೀಟ್
ವೆರಿ ಸ್ವೀಟ್ ನಾರ್ಮಲ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ವೈಟ್ ರೈಟ್
ಹಾ
ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಲೈಟ್ ರೆಡ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಲೈಟ್
It's like a pinkish, peach color.
A peach color. It's very tasty.
Yeah.
You will like it.
It's too sweet though?
Not too sweet. It's nice. It's like a regular banana. Regular banana will be in not whatever white cream color. This is little light peachish. ಟೊಮೆಟೊ ಚಟ್ನಿ ಇಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸಲೆಂಟ್ ತುಂಬ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿದೆ ರೀ ಚಟ್ನಿಗಳು ಎಷ್ಟು ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿದೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾ
ಟೊಮೆಟೊ ಚಟ್ನಿ
ಟೊಮೆಟೊ ಚಟ್ನಿ ತುಂಬ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿದೆ ಕೋಕೋನಟ್ಟು ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿದೆ ಗುಡ್ ಸಾಂಬಾರ್
ದ ಕಡ್ಬು ದಟ್ ಶ್ರೀ ಇಸ್ ಈಟಿಂಗ್ ನೌ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಪುಂಡಿ ಇನ್ ಮ್ಯಾಂಗಲೋರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ಅವರ್ ಫೇವರೇಟ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಟು ಈಟ್ ಸೊ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಬೇಸಿಕಲಿ ರೈಸ್ ಡಂಪ್ಲಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಸಮ್ ಕೋಕೋನಟ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಸ್ಟೀಮ್ಡ್ So it's a very healthy sort of a
breakfast.
I think whether you do breakfast or lunch or dinner, it also has the texture where you can break it down, pour some curry over it, reconstitute that into tiny dumplings and then savor.
Pundi is very nice just like that itself.
So how many pundis are you going to be eating?
I ate about 5-6, so I cannot eat more than that.
It's about balancing food and exercise, right? That's something that Shree believes in. So she believes in eating healthy, in eating what's right. So at home, most of the things that we do are organic.
A lot of vegetables, even whatever sambar and anything you make, I try to put 3-4 different types of vegetables. Greens, palak, amaranth, fenugreek. This weekly 3 times I make the spinach, maybe 3 different vegetables.
So it's all about eating right, eating the right vegetables and mostly organic. Good morning.
Good morning, sir.
How are you doing?
Fine, fine. How are you?
I'm doing well. Shri is enjoying the kadupu pundi. Yeah, she says the chutneys are terrific.
Okay.
Sir.
My intermittent fasting.
Ah, you told me that.
Yeah, so I will do lunch directly. Okay. So I told him, I said, save some kadubu for me.
Sure.
Even this baale is tumba chennagide.
It's because of color, they say kendali.
Kendali.
Kendali, kempu.
So that's Mr. Charles Baptist, the owner of The Vintage.
Hello, sir.
It's great to see his passion for food, for nature, for this lovely fruit orchard that he has. How did you get into this?
Actually, my dad, you know, like, he was working in the coffee estates with the Europeans and all. So when we were small children, you know, we used to go there for holidays and all. That is the time, you know, like, I got interested, you know. Always I used to dream that, you know, I should also build a house, something like that.
Okay.
That was my dream, and now maybe it has come true.
It has come true. And now you're sharing that dream with the world as well. So I think for city folks like us who can only dream of this and that the fact that you're sharing this world with people like us is nice. So how did that happen?
That actually, because I was doing some other business and all, and I was not doing very well in that. And then that is the time, since I had passion also, I thought, okay, let me start with this. Then I started in the month of Jan, and Jan and February, I really did well.
2020. Okay.
Then it's word of mouth, you know, like maybe the guests who have come here, they liked our service, maybe food and the cleanliness here and the greenery, you know, all that they liked it. And that is how now it is continuing.
And so how many rooms are there here?
I have 3 villas here.
Okay.
One villa, it is with 4 bedrooms. And the second villa called LJ, that has actually 3 interconnected rooms and 2 dormitories have. Okay. So in total, I can accommodate about 32 people.
32 people.
Yeah. But after this COVID, have restricted, you know, taking people. The max I would take about 15 only.
15 people. Yeah. So I had put up a post on Instagram asking for, recommendations on homestays, because I wanted to stay in a homestay this time. The Vintage came up as a recommendation. And then I got about 300 odd comments speaking of different places, etc. And it was a Herculean task to navigate through all that. And then when I came to The Vintage, I think one of the things that really got me excited about The Vintage was the fact that Mr. Charles Baptist himself spends time in the kitchen, is passionate about the food. So he's closely looking at that. And I think when you're on a holiday, you know, in a home, I think the one thing that connects you to a land or to a place or its people is the food.
Yes.
And because I knew that he was personally involved, I think that's the reason why we said, okay, fine, let's try this out. Of course, it's relatively new as opposed to many other places that have been around for a while. Yes. And I've just had 2 meals here, but I'm really happy with whatever I've tasted. And of course, Shri is very happy with our kadubu.
Superb, simply brilliant.
Yeah. So what are the plants that you have in your orchard?
I have chiku plants, lychee, gooseberries, rose apples, water apple, and Alfonso mango. That is from Ratnagiri.
Oh, okay.
And this bananas, red bananas. We call it as kendali here locally.
Kendali.
Yeah.
And of course, plenty of jackfruit.
Varieties of jackfruits. Varieties, you know, they call honeydew and red color ones and Malaysian. And one more we have that the whole year you'll get jackfruit in that. Red color is there. Yes. It's March, April.
So I'm sure Shri will make
that's
another trip
favorite
here in March, April.
That's my favorite.
I'll make sure that I'll send one.
Because yakandre nan Jainagar hogi huduktini orange color red didiya andre illa madam sikkilla anta heltare.
So 100% nimge vandu ma'am, ee season alli I will send it to you.
Okay, it's on tape now. She will not let you.
No, without tape also I'll make sure that I will send it.
So sweet.
It's so tasty.
How do
it's very gum in alla. No gum. ಅಂಡ್ ಅದು ಒಂಥರ ಆರೆಂಜ್ ಇದ್ರೆ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಹುಳಿ ಹುಳಿ ಟೇಸ್ಟ್
ತುಂಬಾ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿರುತ್ತೆ. ನಾನೇನ್ ಗೊತ್ತಾ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ, ಅದ್ರೊಳಗಡೆ ಸೀಡ್ ಇದೆಯಲ್ಲ, ಆ ಸೀಡ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಡ್ರೈ ಮಾಡಿಬಿಟ್ಟು ಪಲ್ಯ ತರ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಸಾಂಬಾರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಸಾಂಬಾರ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹಾಕ್ತೀನಿ ನಾನು ಆ ಸೀಡ್ನ, ತುಂಬಾ ಟೇಸ್ಟಿ.
Just checking on a new video that we released this morning, a motor vlog. On my ride to Vijayapura, where we tasted the Nani Hotel Masal Dosa and also the Chikkuveerana sweet stall Mysore Pak, Badam Halwa and some delicious jalebis fried in ghee. So even though I may be on a break of sorts, I am clued in seeing what's happening, how people are reacting to our content. Looking at comments, replying to a certain extent. You know, when it comes to my work, you know, there is no differentiation between my life or let's say my lifestyle and work. I call it work because you need to call something work, but it's typically an extension of what I do, whether it's food, whether it's motorcycling, and we create content out of it and we showcase it on our channels. Of course, you also call it work because it helps pay some of the bills. So I don't really mind, even though I'm on a break, checking in and seeing what's happening. Stay tuned for our upcoming vlog. If you enjoyed the watch, don't forget to like, share and hit the subscribe button. We will see you on the next one. Bye-bye.